sentence number 103, English explanation, directions 76 to 77. A sentence is divided into four parts. The error, if any, will be one part of the sentence. The number of the part is your answer. So 76, I have been knowing Asha for 15 years, but I do not know where she lives. Now, sir, problem is in this area. K-N-O-W, no, will never take ing with it. Okay, so we have to do what, sir? Cut down that bin. So I have known Asha, that's all. Okay, I have known Asha for 15 years. So A problem, A area. So for 76, A option is the answer. Question number 77, under the same direction. If Parinita had a few hours to spare, she would spend in the public library. People have so much problem with this particular thing, sir, called a few, the few and few. Now, sir, here what we are getting, Parinita got some time, okay? Minimum time is there. So a few is absolutely fine, okay? After that, sir, to spare, she would spend in that public library. So that minimum time also she will get, she will go to public library, and everything is fine here. After would also v1 is used only, so grammatical and everything is fine. So our answer is no error, sir. Okay, so for 77, answer will be no error, option number D. Directions 78 to 79. Pick out the most effective word from the given words to fill in the blanks to make the sentence meaningfully complete. So, question from fillers, sir. Okay. So, let us check first. Question from fillers. 78 number question. Rakesh seemed most amenable dash my idea. Now, first of all, we have to know the word meaning amenable. Meaning is, sir, comfortable. Okay. Now, someone seemed most comfortable to my idea, because, sir, whenever we are saying something, when we are telling something to someone else, idea or suggestion or whatever it is, that has a particular what, sir, that has a particular direction, that that thing will go to people and people will understand that or never understand that. So that has a direction. So only Rakesh seemed most amenable or comfortable to my idea. Okay, so for 78, A is the answer. So for 78, A, TO2 is the answer. Question number 79, under the same direction, fillers. So it would be a very good idea if Geeta dash his permission first. Options are get, have got, and is getting. So what is written here, sir? Would be. Fine. So what we know already, sir, in main clause, would plus be is there, then if clause will take what, sir? Only V2. Okay, so we are getting got here. So here, that's why GOT got. Okay, so it would be a very good idea if Geeta got his permission first. So C79 is the answer. Question number 80. In the following question, a sentence has been given in active or passive voice. Out of the four alternatives suggested, select the one which best expresses the same sentence in passive or active voice. So let us read the question first. Here is the question, sir. The students are decorating the clubhouse for the annual day celebrations. Okay. So what is written here, sir? Are decorating, present continuous tense, meaning, sir, verb plus ing, and whenever any active to passive voice we have to do, active voice as verb plus ing, then we already know, sir, that being, being plus v3 should be used there. Okay, so let us find this thing. A, the clubhouse is being decorated by the students for the annual day celebration. Not possible, sir. I told being, not been. Next one, the clubhouse is decorated by the students. Being is nowhere, sir, so we should not read. Okay, see, the clubhouse is being decorated, we already got, sir, is, then being, then v3. So the clubhouse is being decorated by the students for the annual day celebration, we already got our answer. So for 80, C is the answer. So for 80, C is the answer. Question number 81. In the following question, a sentence has been given in direct or indirect speech. out of the four alternatives suggested, select the one which best expresses the same sentence in indirect or direct speech. So our question is here, sir. Mrs. Gray said, Alice, my only daughter is no more. So what is at the end, sir? At the end, there is exclamatory sign, and as exclamatory sign is there, we already know that only and only exclaimed or exclaimed we can use. Fine. So here is what sir said. So we have to use exclaimed only. Other things we will not read. Okay. So A option, Mrs. Gray exclaimed with sorrow that her only daughter was no more. B, Mrs. Gray exclaims with sorrow that her only daughter was no more. But sir, what is here exclaims? We will not take B. C option, Mrs. Gray exclaims again, sir, will not read as it will waste the time. D, Mrs. Gray exclaimed with sorrow that her only daughter is again here, sir. Problem again. Why, sir, problem? Because I already told past tense is there. Everything will become past tense totally. Okay, everything in that particular direct, in the inverted comma, everything will be in past tense. If it is written in universal truth, then only you cannot make it in past. But other things, everything is past. So only and only we are getting past tense in A everywhere. Mrs. Gray exclaimed with sorrow, obviously, sir, someone's daughter is no more. So with sorrow that her only daughter was no more. Okay, so our for question number 81, A is the answer. Question number 82. In the following question, mention the option which gives the proper one word for the group of words. So make a killing is the phrase here. So make money quickly, plan a murder properly, a cold-blooded murder, lose money quickly. So make a killing, sir. We have to know, sir, this means make money quickly. Okay. So for 82, make money quickly is the answer. So for 82, A, make money quickly is the answer. Question number 83. In the following question, the sentence may or may not need any improvement. Choose the option that can improve the bold part. If there is no need of improvement, mark D as your answer. So let us read it, sir, first. Rakesh is as tall, if not than Ankit. Okay, what we got, sir? As tall, if not than. Okay, so sir, we are getting if then. So this area is totally completed, but as tall, something is not there in this area. So as tall as should be there, because sir, as is giving you the positive sense or positive degree of comparison. So without completing one degree totally or properly, we can't go to the other part of the sentence. So let us read, sir. Not taller as, not so tall as tall as, if not, no improvement. So we got, sir, as tall as, then if not. So C is the answer, sir. As tall as, here it will be one as, then comma, then if not, then Ankit. Okay, so Rakesh is not as tall as, if not that Ankit. So for 83, C is the answer. Directions 84 and 85. In the following question, the first and last part of this passage is numbered 1 and 6. The rest of the passage is split into four parts and named P, Q, R, and S in small. There are four parts. These four parts are not given in proper order. Find out which four is combinations is correct. So as I already told all of you, number one sentence, the given statement is general statement, the most general one, and the number six is your most specific one. Okay, so let us read, sir. Afghan officials say a roadside bomb has struck a civilian vehicle going to a wedding. After that, now sir, its roadside bomb has struck already, it's bombed, so or burst out. So after that, it killed people. So killing at least 15 people, almost all of them women and young girls. After that, sir, how many persons? Let us fix them. Nusrat Rahimi, an interior ministry spokesman, say two other civilians then, sir, were wounded in the blast in the northeastern Kunduz province. Okay, so that particular bomb struck and killed 15 people. All of them are women and young girls. And Nusrat Rahimi, interior ministry spokesman, told that two other civilians were also wounded in the blast in the northeastern Kunduz province, where it happened actually. After that, Sanonli R is there. He says six women, six girls, and two infants died in the explosion, as well as the male driver. What is the name of that person? Enamuddin Rahmani, police spokesman for Kunduz province, confirmed the report. Okay, so this is a thing, sir. So we are getting for 84 PSQR as our answer. So we are getting 84 PSQR as our answer. P, then number 2, S, then Q, then R. Okay, question number 85 under the same direction. As I already told, sentence number 1 is general statement. Sentence number 1 is general statement. And number 6 is specific statement, the most specific one. Okay, so let us read. Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern offered an official apology Thursday on the 40th anniversary of New Zealand's worst peacetime disaster, the Mount Erebus air crash in which 257 people died. After that, sir, number 2 will be Q. An Air New Zealand DC-10 on a sightseeing flight over Antarctica slammed into remote Mount Erebus. Okay. After that, sir, during white out conditions on the frozen continent on November 28, 1979, killing all on board, then, sir, that loss in and of itself was huge. It sent ripples across the country, but that loss and grief was compounded. Fine. So here we are getting, sir, SQRP as our answer. So we are getting, sir, SQRP as our answer for this 185. Question number 86. In the following question, out of the four alternatives, choose the best meaning of the phrase used here. So what is the phrase, sir? Let us read first. Then, bite off more than you can chew. What is the meaning, sir? Something I gave you, you took that much that you can't even chew, but you already put that in your mouth. Fine. So ABCD options are an easy task or job, the entire thing, all of something, lose a lot of money, try to take on a task too big for oneself. Meaning I gave you a plate of biryani and even you can't chew that much you put in your mouth. So that is a very big task for you and you can't complete it right now. So you are trying to complete it. So D is your answer, sir. Fine. So for 86, D is our answer. Question number 87. In each question below, four words printed in bold type are given, numbered as ABCD. One of these words printed in bold might either be wrongly spelled or is inappropriate. In the context of the sentence, find out the word that is incorrectly spelled, if any. The number of the word is your answer. So, words are proscience, demetus, malfeasance, and foudroyant. Okay, so let us check, sir. Proscience is absolutely correctly spelled, sir. The meaning of this word is knowing something in advance. Knowing something in advance. Fine. After that, demetus, meaning a small cup of strong coffee. Small cup of strong coffee. Fine. That is called demetus. And malfeasance is also absolutely correctly spelled, sir. The meaning is wrongful conduct by public officials, meaning when they are not conducting with us properly, then that will be called malfeasance, wrongful conduct. Then, sir, this word foudroyant. Here, sir, this particular U, you people are watching, sir, this U should not be there. So your word will be like this, sir, F-O-U-D-R-O, foudroyant, that's all. No U in between of O and Y. Clear? What is the meaning of this word? The meaning of this word I am writing here, sir, is terrible. Okay? The meaning of this word is terrible. So as we got one spelling mistake here, sir, so D is our answer here. So D is our answer here. For question number 87, D is the answer. Directions 88 to 89. In the following question, choose the word opposite in meaning to the given word. Okay, so antonym. Equitable is the word, sir. As we already know, equitable meaning, sir, fair or impartiality. No partiality is there. Okay, so troubled, then fair, then unfair, then separated. All the meanings everybody knows. Fair is one synonym of. So antonym is asked, sir. So unfair or partiality is our answer, sir. Okay. So for question number 88, C, unfair is the answer. Question number 89, under the same direction, antonym or opposite. Okay. So what we are getting, sir? Antagonist. Option, sir. Hero, scribe, Tito Taylor and Ali. Antagonist meaning, sir, we have to know first. Antagonist meaning opponent or resister. Someone who resists always. Fine. Hero, everybody knows. Scribe meaning one who writes, or penman, or journalists are also called scribes, sir. Fine. One who writes. Fine. Tito Taylor. Tito Taylor meaning one who never drinks. One who never drinks alcohol. That person is called Tito Taylor. Ali meaning is, sir, friendly or friend. So as we are getting antagonist meaning what, sir? Opponent, resistor, or someone who resists or opposing. But sir, friends will never oppose, sir. So our answer will be D. So for question number 89, antagonist, our answer is Ali, sir. Option number D. Directions 90 to 91. In the following questions, choose the word similar in meaning to the given word. So similar is here, sir, so synonym. Okay. So word is in 90, barren. Options are sterile, fertile, fruitful, and productive. So barren meaning is, sir, bare. B-A-R-E, bare, or empty, or infertile. Fine. This much meanings are there, sir. Okay. So sterile. Sir, sterile meaning is, sir, infertile only. I'm writing out here again, not fertile, infertile. Fine. Fertile, as we are giving a similar, sir, it's the antonym, obviously, opposite fertile. Okay. Fruitful and productive, both are giving the sense of, sir, outcome or result. Okay. So as synonym is asked, sir, for barren, sterile is the answer. Barren, sterile is the answer, and fertile is the answer of what, sir? Fertile is the answer of this one, antonym. Okay, so for barren, you can use fertile as an antonym, but as similar, so for 90, A is the answer, sterile. Okay, question number 91, under the same direction, similar in meaning or synonym, what is proxy, sir? Okay, proxy meaning act for another. When you can act for another, when that will be assigned to you. Okay, so act for another, or when it will be assigned for you, then only you can act for another. So options, sir, erudite, delegate, hegemony, closeness. One by one meaning, sir. Hegemony meaning dominance of leadership. Dominance of leadership. Fine. Delegate. Delegate is actually assigning some work to someone. An erudite meaning scholar or learned person. Scholar or learned person. So for 99, B, delegate is our synonym, sir. Okay, as the sent word is giving the sense of assigning. Okay, so for 91, B, delegate is the answer. So for 91, B, delegate is the answer. Directions 92 to 96. Read the given passage carefully and answer the questions that follow. As I told in CGL, directly go to the question and then choose. Question number 92. Choose the option which is the most opposite or antonym to the word in the question as mentioned in the passages. Horrific, sir. Horrific meaning is something which causing horror. something which causing horror to you. Fine. So options are delectable, defiance, appalling, and atrocious. Atrocious meaning evil. Atrocious meaning evil. Defiance meaning rebelliousness or rebel type of person who will not listen to anything. Okay, rebelliousness. Appalling meaning alarming. Alarming. And the word called delectable meaning pleasing. P-L-E-S-I-N-G. Pleasing or soothing, sir. Okay. So let us find out which is the opposite. Something is causing horror to your mind and something soothes your mind. So obviously delectable is the answer first, sir, for 92. So for 92A, delectable or pleasing or soothing is the answer. Okay, that is in option A for 92. Question number 93. Choose the option which is most opposite to the word in the question as mentioned in the passage. And the word is, sir, celebrate. Okay, so let us find out. Honor, rejoice, castigate, glorify. So now, celebrate meaning we are enjoying, we are celebrating. So honor, rejoice, and glorify all are synonym. Only the word castigate or cutting is the opposite of it. So for 93C, castigate is our answer. So for 93C, castigate is our answer. Question number 94. Which of the following is or are incorrect according to the passage that we have to read, sir? The accident occurred near Mamallapuram of the East Coast Road at around 11:30 p.m. on Tuesday. The bike was being driven by 19-year-old Bharat and Delhi. A 15-year-old girl and unidentified youth were reportedly riding pillion. And three, the deceased has been identified as an 18-year-old girl, a resident of New Colony in Annanagar, among others. So we have to find out the incorrect one. Now, let us read, sir. The bike, from here read, sir. The bike was being driven by 19-year-old Bharat. It's there. And Delhi, a 15-year-old girl and unidentified youth were reportedly riding pillion. So after that, sir, according to sources, the four were coming from Mamallapuram to Chennai on a two-wheeler. After filling fuel for the bike near Mamallapuram, Bharat was riding on the wrong side when a minivan going towards Puducherry hit their vehicle at a turning, throwing all four onto the road. Okay, after that, sources say three of them, including the girl, died on the spot. After that, the deceased have been identified, a 15-year-old girl. But what is written here, sir, the deceased has been identified as 18-year-old girl. Okay, a resident of New Colony in Annanagar, Delhi, of Parambakkam, Solingar, and Bharat of Water Tank Colony in Kottapuram. So here, sir, we are getting 15-year-old girl and here we are getting 18-year. So 3 is incorrect, sir. So in A option, only 3 is written. So for 94A, only 3 is the answer. So for 94A option, only 3 is the answer. Question number 95. Which of the following places have not been mentioned in the passage? Options are Mamallapuram, Perubakkam, Solinganallur, and Vandaluram. So let us check, sir. Here we are getting Mamallapuram. Okay. Here we are getting Annanagar. Here we are getting New Colony. Here we are getting Kottapuram. You are getting particular Solinganallur and Perubakkam. All the words are here, all the name of the places. But Vandaluram is nowhere, sir. So 4 is wrong. So we are getting only 4 in A option. So for 95, A is the answer. So for 95, A is the answer. Question number 96. Which of the following words are not the antonym of the given word escape mentioned in the given passage? So everybody should know the meaning of the escape. Meaning of the escape is flight or evasion or fleeing from some area, escaping. Options are evade. Evade meaning escape, sir. So synonym. Captivity. Captivity meaning, let me write it down here. Captivity meaning imprisoned, okay, or jailed or locked up. Jailed or locked up, fine. And elope. Elope meaning also run away or flee. So Evade and elope, both are what, sir? Both are synonym for the word named escape. Only not the antonym. So we are getting captivity as the antonym, sir. Fine. And what is asked, sir? Not the antonym. Meaning synonym is asked actually. So one evade and three elope, both are synonym. So we are getting one and three in C option, sir. So for 96C is the answer. So for 96C is the answer. Question number 97. Out of the given four alternatives, choose the option that is equal in meaning to the given group of words. So one was substitution again, sir. To expel someone from a position or place. Expel meaning we should know first. Expel meaning removing. Fine. Expel meaning removing. So let us read. To oust, to disinherit, to chase, to relegate. One by one, sir. Meanings. Relegate meaning passing. Pass or submit, sir. Pass or submit. Okay. Disinherit meaning throwing someone outside. No inheritance. Fine. Like property is there, you can't, you will not get it, so you are disinherited. Chase meaning everybody knows, sir. Oust meaning is remove from a position. Remove from a position. So here we are getting what, sir? To expel someone from a position. And oust meaning is also remove from a position. So for 97A is the answer. So for 97A is the answer for question number 97, to oust. Okay. Question number 98. Out of the given four alternatives, choose the antonym of the given word. So opposite. Odium, and options are affection, antipathy, bruish, and deform. Odium meaning we have to know first. Odium meaning is hate someone, okay, with extreme disgust. Hate someone with disgust. Fine. Disgusting type of hate, sir. So affection. Affection meaning love. Okay. Antipathy. Antipathy meaning not sympathy or opposite of sympathy. Bruish meaning hurt or injure. Hurting someone or injuring someone. And deform meaning no form is there. So formless or abstract. Okay. So odium meaning hate, sir. Okay. And we are getting what, sir? Affection. What is the meaning right now? I told intense love. So obviously everybody knows love and hate. Hate and love is the opposite. Antonym is asked. So for 98, affection is the answer. So for 98, affection is the answer. Question number 99. Out of the given four alternatives, choose a synonym of the given word. So word is exorcise. Fine. Listen, sir, exercise is also there. Exorcise is also there. Options are expel, entertain, explain, and enigmatic. So exorcise meaning is, sir, expel through prayers. Expel through prayers. Fine. Now everybody should know, sir, expel, entertain, explain, and enigmatic. Expel meaning kick out or throw out. Okay, so you are expelling someone or kicking out or throwing out someone through what, sir? Prayers. That is the meaning of exorcise. So we are already got the word, sir, expel. So our 99 A, expel is the answer. Entertain, explain, and enigmatic words, I think everybody knows. Still enigmatic meaning, everyone. Puzzling situation, confusing situation. Okay. Or uncomprehensible. Or uncomprehensible is another word for the word enigmatic. So for 99A, expel is the answer. Question number 100. Out of the given four alternatives, choose the meaning of the given idiom. What is the idiom, sir? Idiom is touch and go. So options are to waste, dangerous and uncertain, conduct secretly, and present and certain. So something came, something touched you, and that thing went out. So you will feel ridiculous at that time, sir, when someone is touching you and someone is just going at that from that area. So if it is happened in public place, then obviously, sir, it is dangerous and uncertain. It should not be happened. Okay. So for 100 number, touch and go, be dangerous and uncertain is our answer. To get all the notifications and new uploaded videos, subscribe to our YouTube channel ISCE and click the bell icon.